Imagine standing ringside at Madison Square Garden in 1987. The air crackles with electricity as a young Mike Tyson unleashes a devastating right hook that sends his opponent crashing to the canvas like a fallen Nazgul. The raw power displayed that night would become legendary, a punch measuring an astonishing 1,800 pounds of force, enough to knock out a horse. But this isn't even our peak. In 2017, UFC heavyweight Francis Ngannou shattered records with a punch registering 129,000 units on the power cube, equivalent to getting hit by a Ford Escort at full speed. That's the kind of force that would make even All Might from My Hero Academia raise an eyebrow. The human fist, this remarkable weapon that we've evolved over millions of years, continues to break barriers we once thought impossible. And yet, as we witness these superhuman displays of power, a fascinating question emerges. Just how hard can a human theoretically punch? What are the absolute limits of our striking power? 3 million years before the first boxing ring was built, our ancestors were already throwing punches. Fascinating fossil evidence shows that Australopithecus had reinforced facial bones, not unlike modern boxers, suggesting that face punching played a crucial role in male competition. But the real game changer came around 2 million years ago with the emergence of Homo habilis and their revolutionary anatomical upgrade, the ability to form a tight fist. This wasn't just a random mutation. Our unique hand structure, with its shorter palms and perfectly aligned knuckles, created what scientists call force multiplication. Think of it like forging the One Ring, but instead of concentrating dark power, our evolution concentrated striking force. Studies show that a clenched fist can deliver 55% more force while protecting those precious finger bones, giving our ancestors a significant advantage in both survival and mate selection. Fast forward to the early 1900s, and we see this evolutionary gift being refined into an art form. Jack Dempsey's ghosting punch could knock out opponents so fast that early film cameras struggled to capture the movement. By the 1960s, Muhammad Ali was demonstrating that speed could be just as devastating as raw power, his rapid-fire combinations landing at a blistering 200 milliseconds per punch, faster than the blink of an eye. The progression of punching power has been exponential. In the 1950s, the average professional heavyweight's punch generated around 600 pounds of force. By the 1970s, it had doubled. Today's elite fighters can generate upwards of 2,000 pounds of force, a tenfold increase compared to untrained individuals who average around 150 to 250 pounds of force. It's like comparing a gentle spring breeze to a Category 5 hurricane. Let's break down what actually happens in the quarter second it takes to throw a punch. And believe me, it's more complex than mastering all 8 gates in Naruto. Your body transforms into a living, breathing physics equation that would make Newton proud. It all starts from the ground up, like a power station generating electricity. Your legs, containing the largest muscles in your body, initiate a kinetic chain. The force begins in your calves and thighs, transferring through your hips like a biological transmission system. Your core muscles, those abs you've been working on, act like power cables, channeling the energy upward. Finally, your shoulder, arm, and fist become the delivery system for all this concentrated force. Here's where the numbers get wild. When an elite boxer throws a punch, they're not just moving their arm. They're coordinating 120 muscles to work in perfect harmony. The acceleration, their fist can reach speeds of 25 miles per hour in less than 6 inches of space. At the moment of impact, a professional heavyweight's punch carries around 5,000 newtons of force, or 1,124 pounds. That's like being hit by a 170-pound anvil thrown from a second-story window. Let's get even more specific with the science here. When a punch lands, it creates what physicists call impulse, the change in momentum over a tiny fraction of time. Elite boxers can generate an impulse of 200 Newton seconds in just 0.03 seconds of contact time. But here's where it gets wild. They achieve this by optimizing something called the double peak force pattern. The first force peak comes from initial impact, and the second, larger peak comes from what scientists call follow-through momentum. It's like charging up a spirit bomb in Dragon Ball Z. The real damage comes from that second energy surge. Studies using electromyography sensors show that elite fighters' punches activate muscles in this precise sequence. Leg muscles fire at 370 milliseconds before impact, generating 38.46% of total force. Hip rotation initiates at 300 milliseconds, contributing 37.42%. Trunk muscles engage at 220 milliseconds, adding 15.89%. Arm muscles activate at 120 milliseconds, 8.23%. This is why you can't just have strong arms. There are a lot of videos where a small skinny guy who is an amateur in boxing knocking out a huge bodybuilder guys who can't coordinate their body to punch. It's all about that full body coordination. It's like a symphony orchestra. If one instrument plays at the wrong time, the whole performance suffers. Welcome to the era where punching power isn't just measured by knockouts, but by sophisticated technology that would make Tony Stark jealous. The Power Cube, a high-tech punching analyzer used by UFC, has revolutionized how we quantify striking force. But before we dive into today's records, let's break down what these numbers actually mean. When Francis Ngannou hit the power cube with 129,161 units in 2017, it wasn't just a number. It was a revolution in our understanding of human striking potential. To put this in perspective, that's equivalent to getting hit by a Ford Escort going at maximum speed, or being kicked by a fully grown male horse. The average adult male generates about 150 to 250 units on the same scale, meaning Francis's punch was roughly 500 times more powerful than an untrained person's. But it's not just about raw power. Modern measurements have revealed fascinating patterns in elite fighters' striking mechanics. Boxing legend Manny Pacquiao, weighing just 145 pounds, can generate over 800 pounds of force in his left hook, more than 5.5 times his body weight. Meanwhile, former heavyweight boxing champion Deontay Wilder's right cross has been measured at an astronomical 1,600 pounds of force, enough to crush a watermelon like it was made of paper. The numbers get even more interesting when we look at professional fighters' hand speed. Modern high-speed cameras have captured punches traveling at speeds up to 32 miles per hour, with the fastest jabs clocking in at just 40 milliseconds from start to impact. Well, that's faster than a cobra strike. At these speeds, the human eye can't even track the movement, which is why so many knockouts seem to come from nowhere. So, what's stopping us from punching even harder? Let's talk about hysterical strength. Those incredible moments when normal people perform superhuman feats under extreme stress. We've documented cases of mothers lifting cars to save their children, as we have talked in the video How Heavy Humans Can Theoretically Lift. Ordinary woman Angela Cavallo, with no sports background, lifted a one side of 3,500-pound Chevy Impala, rescuing her trapped son. While the world deadlift record is 1,104 pounds by Hafter Bjornsson, aka The Mountain, But what about fighting? There are documented cases of untrained individuals delivering punches with extraordinary force during life or death situations. One notable case in 2016 involved a Tennessee man who knocked out an armed attacker with a single punch that fractured the attacker's skull, a feat requiring over 2,000 pounds of force. The numbers behind this phenomenon are staggering. During hysterical strength episodes, the human body increases motor unit recruitment from the typical 50 to 60% to nearly 100%, floods the system with norepinephrine, increasing force production by up to 175%, temporarily enhances bone density to withstand forces up to 900 Newton meters, can activate type 2X muscle fibers that are usually reserved for emergency use. A 2021 study in the Journal of Applied Physiology found that under extreme stress, the average person can temporarily access up to 44% more strength than their tested maximum. The secret lies in our brain's limiting mechanisms. Your nervous system typically restricts your muscle power to about 65% of its true maximum to prevent injury. There is a contemporary theory in MMA where, for example, during his prime, Chuck Liddell's strong chin was as his defense. He couldn't get knocked out no matter how hard he got hit. That's not good for the brain and the body. So when he got punched in the chin so much that it's getting dangerous, Chuck Liddell started to lose brutally by getting knocked out. As soon as he got hit to his chin, even lightly, his brain switched his body off, preventing him injuring himself getting hit again. But during moments of extreme stress, these neural inhibitors can be temporarily bypassed, allowing access to nearly 100% of our muscle power. But there's a catch. Our bodies aren't built to handle this kind of force regularly. The human hand contains 27 bones, and at maximum theoretical output, we risk shattering them like glass. Our tendons and ligaments, which have a tensile strength of around 50 to 150 megapascals, would be pushed to their absolute limits. Scientists estimate that the theoretical maximum force a human could generate in a punch before the body starts breaking down is around 6,000 pounds of force, or roughly the impact of a one-ton wrecking ball swinging at 20 miles per hour. But what if we could transcend these biological limitations? We're standing on the precipice of a revolution in human enhancement that would make the super soldier serum look primitive. Genetic engineering, particularly CRISPR technology, has already created mice with twice the normal muscle mass by suppressing myostatin, the protein that limits muscle growth. Now imagine, what if that applied to human fighters? Scientists are also developing synthetic tendons that are 5 times stronger than natural ones, and carbon fiber bone reinforcements that could theoretically allow our skeletal structure to withstand forces that would shatter normal bones. We're not talking about becoming cyborgs like Genos from One Punch Man. This is about pushing the boundaries of what's biologically possible. Recent advances in biomechanical engineering have revealed some mind-blowing possibilities. Carbon nanotube reinforced tendons could theoretically withstand forces up to 280 megapascals. Regular human tendons can handle about as much force as a thick rubber band before snapping. But carbon nanotube reinforced tendons, they'd be like replacing that rubber band with a steel cable. We're talking about tendons that could withstand the force of a fully loaded semi-truck hanging from them. To put that 280 megapascals in perspective, that's stronger than the cables they use to hold up suspension bridges. Imagine having the equivalent of Golden Gate Bridge cables running through your arms. That's the kind of upgrade we're talking about. CRISPR modified muscle fiber density could increase from the current maximum of 293 fibers per millimeter squared to potentially 400 plus per millimeter squared. Think about the difference between regular paper and military grade Kevlar. Regular paper has loose fibers that easily tear, while Kevlar is packed with super dense fibers that can stop bullets. That's similar to what we're talking about with CRISPR-modified muscles. Current human muscles are like a handful of strings bundled together, but these modified muscles would be like cramming 35% more strings into the same space. Imagine upgrading from a regular USB cable to those super tough braided ones that never break, except this is your actual muscle. Or right now, test this out yourself. Watch this video on 240p and switch to 1080p. That's the upgrade we are talking about, but for your muscles. The theoretical maximum punching force could potentially double or triple with these advancements. A punch delivering 15,000 pounds of force, enough to stop a charging bull, might become possible. But with great power comes great responsibility, and these possibilities raise serious ethical questions about the future of combat sports and human enhancement. Let's bring it all back to our original question. How hard can humans theoretically punch? Right now, we're looking at a natural limit of around 6,000 pounds of force for the genetic elite under perfect conditions. But tomorrow, the sky might be the limit. As we continue to push the boundaries of human potential, one thing becomes clear. We haven't yet seen what the human fist is truly capable of. So the next time you watch a knockout punch, remember, you're not just watching a fight, you're watching millions of years of evolution, perfect biomechanics, and perhaps a glimpse into humanity's enhanced future. Well, thanks for watching. This episode was brought to you with the help of these amazing Patreon supporters. If you want to support this channel and help us create more content like this, head over to Patreon. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button. More fascinating videos are coming up, and trust me, you won't want to miss them.